Father, indeed you are Lord. Every knee must bow at the mention of your name. And every tongue must confess that indeed you are the Lord. Father, we worship your name. We magnify you. We glorify you. We exalt you higher. We have once again assembled, Father, in your presence to listen, Father, to your word. Father, it is my prayer that, Father, come and speak, Father, through me. Lord, speak to me, Father, to your people. Let this message be a message that will transform the life of your dear children. Father, any branch of the enemy that will rise against us this morning, I stand by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth to destroy in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
To cancel in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, bless us through your way, and we will give you all the glory and honor. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
We are talking on the team, you are the chosen of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Tell yourself that I am the chosen of the Lord.
I am the chosen of the Lord.
Oh, you are the chosen of the Lord.
I am the chosen of the Lord.
Oh, amen.
Amen.
Sir, I want you to say after me, I am the chosen of the Lord.
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 Let me understand this. I am the chosen of the Lord. Say to yourself. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, amen.
Amen.
I want us to read Psalm 27, verses 13. Psalm 27, verses 13. Psalm 27, verses 13.
Psalm 27, verse number 13.
Yes.
I have fainted.
Yes.
Unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Oh, amen.
Amen.
David says something. This was the words of David. I read the Amplified Bible. What would have become of me had I not believed that I would see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living? I want the New King James Version. I have fainted unless I have believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Amen.
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 This was the words of him. He said, I would have lost heart. I would have lost heart unless I had believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Beloved, what David was saying was that don't give up in life. Never give up in life. David penned out these words when he found himself in the wilderness taking care of his father's herds. Bible says he was there alone in the wilderness with animals. He was talking to animals. He was playing with animals. He was doing everything with animals. The Bible says his father, his mother, his brothers rejected him. So the Bible says he was there. And he wanted to, you know, give up in life. He thought nobody cares about him. He thought the whole world has come to an end for him. But the Bible says he encouraged himself. In the land of the living. No matter what is happening, no matter what I found myself now, I know one day I'll see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Oh, amen.
Amen.
This was what it is. He was still alone with animals. He was a shepherd boy. Nobody cares about him. I said, I will not allow my present situation to determine my future. life, what I'm going through, to decide my future for you. I would rather believe, I would rather encourage myself that I'm going to see the goodness of the Lord in this land of the living. Beloved, no matter what is happening to you, no matter where you find yourself, what I want you to know is that never give up. Never give up. Never give up in life, because you are going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of this living. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, amen.
Amen.
So the Bible says, it comes to a time that the Lord rejected King Saul. So God sent Prophet Samuel to the house of Jesse to anoint one of his sons as king of Israel. Beloved, when Samuel got to the house of Jesse and he saw the first son of Jesse, that was Eliab, Bible said, looking at his stature, his height, his physical appearance, Samuel said to himself, I perceive that this man is the chosen of the Lord. And after he took his oil and he was about to anoint Eliab, but God says something, that I have not chosen him. I have not chosen him. For man looks at the outward appearance. Man considers the things that he is tall, that he is intelligent, that he is strong. But I go, I look beyond what men can see. I look beyond what men can see. I look beyond the physical appearance. I rather look into the heart. I rather look into the inward man. I rather look into what the person is carrying. Oh, hallelujah. Beloved, it doesn't matter the way people treat you. It doesn't matter the way people see you. God doesn't see what people see you. I said, God doesn't see what people see you. Samuel was thinking that Eliab was in, you know, fine stature. He was a man of stature. He was handsome. So for that matter, he is the chosen of God. And God said, no, I do not consider what men consider. I rather look into the heart. I rather look into the heart. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, beloved, God has chosen you.
Amen.
I'm here to announce to you that God has chosen you. It doesn't matter the way people treat you. I said, God has chosen you. Oh, share a big amen.
Amen.
Oh, amen. Bible said the second time also came to pass. That is Abinadab. And God said, I have not chosen him. The third son came, Shammah. God said, I have not chosen him. And all the seven sons passed. And God said, I have not chosen them. Beloved, you are the chosen of the Lord. I said, you are the chosen of the Lord.
Amen.
Bible says, even the father of David didn't remember that he had got a son named David. It was the prophet who asked. Jesse, let's read something in 1 Samuel chapter 16. 1 Samuel chapter 16. 1 Samuel chapter 16. Verses 11. I like this quotation. The father even didn't remember that he has got a son named David. It was rather the prophet of God who asked him this question. Then such Jesse, by Samuel, are all your sons here? Are all your sons here? This was a question that he asked him. And look at the response of Jesse. Jesus said, There is yet the youngest. He is tending the sheep. He is in acquaintance. He is a shepherd boy. I don't think he deserved to be anointed as king of Israel. In other words, that was what the father was trying to say. Hallelujah. Oh, amen.
Amen.
And look at what someone said. Someone said to Jesse, sit for him. Sit for that your son. I'm talking about the youngest. Sit for him. Whoever he is, sit for him. For you will not sit down. For you will not sit down. For you will not sit down.
Amen.
For you will not sit down. eat. We are not going to drink. But we are going to stand on our feet and wait for that shepherd boy to be here. Because he's the chosen of the Lord. Because he's the chosen of the Lord. The father was considering David as, you know, shepherd boy, an outcast. But God was seeing something within him. That he is the king of Israel. And he carries something that is heavy. Beloved, you carry something that is heavy. Men have not seen it. It is only God who has seen it. So the Bible says, I have not seen, ye has not heard, neither has it entered the heart of any man. The things that God has prepared for those who love you. Oh, hallelujah! So you are the chosen of the Lord. Men don't know who you are. People don't know who you are. It doesn't matter that people look down on you. The Bible says, when all men cast you down, then shall you say there is a lifting up. So it doesn't matter how men treat you. There is a lifting up. 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 So the Bible says promotion comes neither from the east, nor from the west, or the south, but it comes from the Father, the creator of heavens and earth, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel. He lifts one and he pulls the other person down. So it doesn't matter your current situation. It doesn't matter where you find yourself now. I'm here to announce to somebody that there is a lifting up. So when men, all the men cast you down, when men look down upon you, when men reject you, when men treat you with contempt, then shall you say there is a lifting up. So this is, I will not give up. I want to encourage myself in the Lord that I'm going to see the goodness of the Lord in this land of the living. Oh, hallelujah. Tell us that I'll never give up. I'll never give up. I'll never give up. I'll never give up. It doesn't matter what is going on. It doesn't matter what people are saying about me. I will not move by what people say. I will not move by what people define about me. I will not move by what I'm going through right now. I want to be moved by the word of God. What is the word of God saying? He's saying that tell the righteous that it shall be well with him, that he shall eat the fruit of his labor. That is what God is saying. What he's saying, I know the talk that I take towards you. It is not of peace, not of evil, to give you an expected end. To give you an expected end. That is what God is saying about you. And he knows you. And he knows you. And he knows you. Do you say something? I know my Redeemer lives. So it doesn't matter. God knows you. God knows you. God knows you. Oh, so God knows me. Oh, hallelujah. We serve the living God. We serve the living God. We serve the living God. He is the God of Abraham. He is the God of Isaac. He is the God of Israel. If he did it for Isaac, if he did it for Abraham, if he did it for Israel, then it is your turn. Now it is your turn. Now it is your turn. For the Bible says, God is not a man that he should lie, nor a son of man that he should repent. Whatever he has said about you will surely come into manifestation. Will surely come into manifestation. If only you believe, shout a big amen to the name of the Most High God. Amen. Oh, beloved, I want you to be a shepherd. I want you to be a shepherd. Why should I say something like this second half of the year? In fact, we are going to cause heaven to come down.
Amen.
We are going to cause heaven to come down.
Yes,
we are going to cause heaven to come down.
Yes,
we are going to show the world that we serve the living God. We serve the living God. That we serve the living God. Oh, hallelujah. So David said, I would have lost heart. I would have lost heart. I would have rejected my God. In other words, I would have, you know, given up. Unless I had believed that no matter what is going on, I am going to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. In the land of the living. This is what I do. This is what I do when I pray. I say, I will never give up. I will never give up. I know the God of Abraham, Isaac and Israel is with me. And for that matter, I am going to see the goodness of the Lord. When we talk about the goodness of the Lord, what are we talking about? We are talking about the greatness of God. We are talking about the mercy of God. We are talking about the glory of God. So in other words, David was trying to say, I will never give up because the Lord is going to prosper me. The Lord is going to lift me. The Lord is going to make me great. That's the goodness of the Lord. That is the goodness of the Lord. So no wonder that he says something. That goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. 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 You don't understand that issue. All the days. It's not some of the days. So every minute, every hour, every day, every week, every month, every year, you will see the goodness of the Lord in your life. Oh, shout a big amen. Oh, a big amen. So the father forgot about him. It was a prophet who asked him, God, are all these your sons? And he said, no, it is left with that, you know, shepherd boy. Yeah, that shepherd boy, he's the youngest, so I don't think that guy can be a king. That guy can be a king. People see you as you are nothing. People don't know what you are carrying. They don't know what is, you know, within you. They don't know. It's only God. It's only God. Say, so I have not seen. Yes, there's no way people's eye can see what you're carrying. If they have to know, they will start taking you as friend. Hallelujah. So don't worry that people, if you don't call you, it will get to a time that every day they'll call you. Every day they'll call you. And they'll start giving you a name. Uncle, but they don't know you. They don't know you, but they are calling you uncle. He's my uncle. He's my friend, but he just met you once. Hallelujah. Your time is coming. Your time is coming. Your time is coming. But the Bible says in his time, he makes all things beautiful. 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 So Solomon says something in his wisdom that I repent and show under the sun. I repent and show under the sun that the race is not to the street, not the battle to the strong, not bread to men of understanding, not favor to men of skill. But it is this thing that I've realized that it is a matter of time and chance. A matter of time and chance. Your time is coming.
Amen.
Your time is coming.
Amen.
Your time is coming.
Amen.
I can see that God is about to lift you up. He's about to lift you up. But the Bible says, those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall renew their strength. And they shall mount up. In other words, they shall soar, not fly. Yeah. Hallelujah. There is a difference between flying and soaring. Hallelujah. Eagles don't fly. It's rather, you know, that's so small there that do not fly. You are an eagle.
Amen.
You are not going to fly.
Amen.
But you are going to soar. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
So the meaning, when I said I want to preach about this eagle, in the name of soaring and flying, in fact, you take me already. Because there is a different between to soar and to fly. Let me pause here. Next week, or some other time, we will continue that. God, let me prepare that message today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, amen.
Amen.
I want to go by the sermon. Because I don't know. That was when the preaching. ginger, then you start saying things that you have not prepared for. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
So, beloved, what I want you to know is that we serve the living God.
Yes,
Lord. He can just change your story with a trick of an eye.
Yes.
It doesn't matter where you find yourself. Just look unto Jesus.
Yes.
Just look unto Jesus. Just look unto Him. The Bible says He's the author of your life.
Amen.
He is the author of your life. He can just rewrite your story again. He can just rewrite your story again. He can just rewrite your restoring again. He is the conqueror of our life. And he's the finisher. Because he's the finisher of your faith. What does it mean? Then it means whatever you have projected, whatever the Lord has said about you, God will make it into reality.
Amen.
That is the finisher of your faith. Your faith will never be in vain. Your faith will never be in vain. Your faith will never be in vain. So the Bible says the expectation of the righteous shall never be what? Cut off. Put your hands together for the Lord. The God of our feet. The God of our feet. Beloved, as I bring my message to a close, what I want you to know is that wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Then this account have lost out. Unless I had believed that I will see the goodness of the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. The Bible says, for the vision is yet for an appointed time. The vision about you. The prophecy about you. What God has said about you is yet for an appointed time. But at the end, it will speak.
Amen.
It will speak.
Amen.
It will speak.
Amen.
It will speak.
Amen.
The reason why you are not seeing anything is that the vision is not deep. The vision about you is not yet what deep. The Bible says it will not lie. Even though it turns. But wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Because it will surely come to pass.
Amen.
God promised Abraham when he was 75 years. 75, it took 25 years, 25 solid years for the vision to come into manifestation. Because Abraham believed beyond that, that I am going to see what the Lord has said about him. I'm going to be the father of nations. It doesn't matter my age. It doesn't matter what is going through my body. It doesn't matter that all the parts of my body is dead. I know that he who has promised me, he is faithful, he is faithful, he is faithful.
Amen.
And he will do it. It doesn't matter. He didn't look at his physical appearance. Beloved, don't look at what is around you. Don't look at your educational level. Hallelujah. Abraham said, I know he was promised me. He's faithful. He's faithful. He's faithful. He's faithful. Faithful is the Lord. And he will do it. Oh, hallelujah. So the Bible said, what about if people do not believe this our God? Without, change his, identity, without nullifying the faithfulness of God, the Bible said, no, never, never. Whether people believe you or not, our God is still God. He is still God. So let me say something. In the book of Psalm 40, yesterday, Psalm 40,
sorry, dear.
As I bring my message to you,
Psalm 40,
Psalm 40. I love this quotation very, very well. I love this quotation. I waited patiently and expectantly for the Lord. And he inclined to me and heard my cry. I waited patiently and expectantly for the Lord. And he inclined to me and heard my cry. So he waited while he was in the desert, the wilderness. Beloved, right now you may find yourself in the desert. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I wait patiently for the Lord. Wait patiently for the Lord. Waiting does not mean you are wasting your time. Waiting does not mean you are wasting your time. It rather means the appropriate time, the set time, the appointed time, the appointed time. So waiting does not mean wasting. But it rather means training time. God is training you now. He's preparing you. He's equipping you. He's equipping you for your greatest destiny. Oh, hallelujah. So David thought he was wasting time, but God was already preparing him. So the Bible says when he got to a time that David was about know my CV. When I was in the wilderness, it will get to a time, the lion will come and take one of my father's sheep, and I will follow the lion, catch that lion, and then it all shoot out of the mouth. And when the lion tries, you know, to face me, what I do was, you know, coat the beard of that lion and strike the lion down and also kill. Hallelujah. So then he was trying to say, God has prepared me in a wilderness. So if I was able to kill this lion, then I am also able to kill this, you know, uncircumcised and foolish Goliath. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Uncircumcised and foolish Goliath. Oh, hallelujah. God is preparing you. I say he's preparing you. No matter where you find yourself, send yourself a call. Is preparing me to kill Goliath. Oh, hallelujah. Yeah. Oh, hallelujah. Yeah. Oh, hallelujah. Yeah. So the Lord who saved me from the pens of the lion will also save me from this uncircumcised Philistine. How put your hands together, hallelujah.